welcome to my channel. This is your girl Tuwanga Tina. Thank you so much for clicking this video. I'm gonna be doing a makeup video with, you know, a little bit of chit chat. Yeah, so stay tuned and enjoy the video. I went in and did my eyebrows and we're just gonna get into the makeup. So when I was like planning to do this video, I was thinking to myself, what am I gonna talk about? We talk about like some TV shows I've been watching. So I'm using the Fenty Beauty Pore Filter Primer. So all shows are pretty much just trying to adjust to the new normal of the pandemic. Sometimes I watch like just random older movies and stuff, and it was just so weird watching everyone not wearing a mask in public places with people. So now that I've put my primer, I'm just gonna go in and set my primer. I'm very oily skin, so I like to set my primer, and I'm just gonna go with a flat brush and I just set it gently, not too much. I'm gonna talk about three shows that I watch on a regular. Although I will be honest, I hadn't watched The Good Doctor in a long time, so I had to go back and kind of watch some older episodes. I was watching The Good Doctor, Chicago Med, and Grey's Anatomy. So I'm just basically gonna like highlight some of the few stuff that kind of stood out to me, the stuff that made me laugh, the stuff that just made me just, I don't know, like it was just funny to watch everyone in masks, social distancing, temperature checking, like that was a lot. And it really just taps into our reality now. Like this has become our truth, you know, and we don't even know for how long. I'm gonna rate the shows, and on number three is Chicago Med. For me, Chicago Med failed to grasp my attention. I actually do like Chicago Med, and I follow up. If you guys hear any sounds, my son is in the next room. Okay, so the thing about me is like if I'm watching shows, I really wanna feel moved. My neck is slightly darker than my face and my chest, mostly because due to pregnancy I never got my color back. I know I look very ghost-like, but we're gonna fix that in a minute, okay? So the season 6 episode 1, I think it was called When Did We Begin to Change the episode. So I'm gonna be going in with my Maybelline Dream Satin Liquid. I like this foundation. This is like the only drugstore foundation I actually love. It kind of reminds me of my Too Faced foundation. The formula, I'm pretty sure it's a little different, but it kind of reminds me of that. So the shade I'm going in is Coco. So basically, the episode, why I'm saying like it didn't get my attention, it was mostly because they were concentrating on the doctor's personal lives. Yes, they did dab into like the patients. I'm gonna start with Dr. Holstead, who's one of the doctors on the show, and I actually do like his character. His character is very like, you know those characters that are just there, but they do play a role. Like if I see Dr. Holstead leave, I'll feel something type of way, type of thing. So that's how I feel about him. So basically, Dr. Holstead is like super obsessed with the fact that okay, like I'm not difficult with people. I understand that people go through you know, their own crisis, whether you're a doctor or not. I understand that, and I'm not very just too like, you know, insensitive about situations like that. Okay, so Dr. Holstead's girlfriend, I think her name was Dr. Asha, if I'm not mistaken, but her name is Hannah. She is a drug addict and she was going through treatment last season. The very first episode she overdosed, so he was rushing her to the hospital. But before he could be with her, you know, his advantage was he was a doctor. He could go in the room and be with her, opposed to other families who couldn't come in and see their family members, even, you know, because of the social distancing and the separation and how they're trying to minimize the numbers. He had the advantage to go and see her. So he goes in, he's like trying to come in, but there's protocols. He had to sanitize and blah blah blah, take temperature, take COVID test. He was like, I took one in the morning, but he had to take another one. And he goes in and he sees her. Now he has a patient, right? This is where I got so mad. He has a patient who just seems super happy. Now because he's dealing with his own addiction issues with his, you know, girlfriend.
Hi guys, as I'm editing, I realized I missed some information. Basically what I was saying is Dr. Holstead couldn't separate his personal life and his work life, because what was going on in his personal life was making him misjudge and almost misdiagnosing his patients. And also one of the things is I realized they were not wearing masks in common areas. Please forgive me, guys. I'm gonna constantly keep saying Dr. Chow. It's Dr. Choi. Please, I'm so sorry.
We now go into Dr. Charles. Dr. Charles and his daughter are awkward. Now, like I said, I watch it, I don't watch. Sometimes I really don't even be knowing what's going on exactly. I don't know what's the type of relationship Dr. Charles and his daughter has, but every time when I watch them, they're always going through something, okay? Like, there's something going on constantly. Now that I've blended my foundation, I'm just gonna go in with my e.l.f. Hydrating Camel Concealer. This is in the color medium beige, but in here where I live, I've failed to find anything past medium beige. All the colors they have is up to medium beige. So please, drugstores in Canada, do better and consider some of us. You know, like, this is way too light, but I'm just gonna show you how I blend it. And because I do love this, it's a very affordable concealer and the formula is really good, but it's lighter than me, but I do work it. I know how to work it, so I'm just gonna show you guys how I work it. So continuing, Dr. Charles is going through it with his daughter. From what I got, is she snuck out and she got COVID. She spread it to her dad. I think her dad has an underlying condition, I don't know, but something like that. So, and then we have Dr. Chow. Is it Chow? I don't remember his name. And April. I do like April. April is like one of the characters I really do like as well. I feel like they could do more with her character. And she has TB, if I remember correctly. So I don't know if they're together with Dr. Chow, because the last time I know they were just not in good terms, but I don't know. I'm just gonna go with the same blender. I use one blender every time. So I don't know, like, if they're together, but her character, I feel like it could do more for me. And they have their own issues going on as well. So like I say, Chicago Med didn't do much for me. They did, you know, show a couple of patients. One part that got me super sad was April. Was, I don't know if it's actually happening in hospitals where doctors are calling the families through FaceTime, but every show was connecting to, like, the doctors were holding the phones for patients, telling them what's going on. I don't know if that was exactly what's happening in the hospitals. So it means so much to me that I should help them. She was telling Dr. Chow that, and basically he was just super worried about her health. That was pretty much it. The only thing I liked from the show was they did this candlelight thing and say out the patient's name and light a candle for them through their phones. That was pretty much it. That was it. Chicago Med, that's it. They covered the pandemic like that. I was annoyed. I didn't like that episode. So for me, out of the three, it goes to number three. I feel like they could have done better because Chicago Med can really draw your attention, but this time they just failed me. So I am just blending this concealer. So now, because it's like so white and of course way lighter than my skin, I go back in with my foundation and I just blend it on top lightly, also not bringing it back to, like, you know, my skin, but also like trying to highlight all the places. So now for Grey's Anatomy goes second for me, and that's a surprise because I'm a Grey's Anatomy fan. Yo, you can't tell me nothing about Grey's Anatomy, but I will be honest, even as a fan, Grey's Anatomy has lost its spark with me. So the episode was called All Tomorrow's Parties, the first one, and then they had The Center Won't Hold, the second one. So they did premiere two episodes in one night, which I found unnecessary as well, because for me it was like I slept. It's so sad because I've never slept through Grey's Anatomy, no matter how tired I am, but I slept because I was bored. It was boring. It goes second only because I thought they were gonna kill off Dr. Weber's character, but they brought him back. So I was so happy because I love Dr. Weber. He has this sense of humor that's so unintentional. If you remember from last season, Dr. Weber had a cobalt poisoning, which a lot of them, they were unable to diagnose, but DeLuca found it. So Grey's Anatomy goes second only because they did show, like, not having enough tests and how nurses are reusing equipment. They were also showing how the nurses were not having enough PPEs, and, you know, how everybody was in high stress, how everybody was overworked. So for me, Grey's Anatomy goes second for that. But there are another show that really went too much of the personal situation opposed to what's going on with the patient. I feel like they should have had a balance of that. I wasn't a fan of it, okay? I wasn't feeling it like that. It's like, you know, Grey's Anatomy used to be a show that if you watch, I'm trying to remember a show or what episode it was when I actually teared up besides Derek dying. But the episode I watched that made me tear up a little bit was when they had the school shooting, remember? And the students, they were doing a candlelight, and the hospital had gone through their own school hospital shooting when that madman was going around shooting everybody. That episode, it really grasped my emotions. I was expecting something on this episode. Do you get what I'm saying? Because it is actually a very serious issue. It's something that's happening in the world. It's not. And it's a sad situation, although the memes are funny. You know, Dr. Weber comes back. Bailey's giving him a tour of, you know, the facilities, what is going on, what is happening, where they need help. Teddy tries to go back to Owen. Owen is not having it, which rightfully so, he shouldn't be having it, because Teddy, man, goddamn, you know, I've been shipping Teddy and Owen since Christina Yang was there. I never liked Christina and Teddy. I feel like Christina's partner, the only partner that I feel like was for her, was Burke, okay? All these other people that came in between, Christina as a character agitated me. I know a lot of people are not gonna be feeling this, but Chris, if you guys want a part two of Grey's Anatomy, let me know, because I didn't like Christina like that. And even my sister, she always gets like super shocked when I say that, but Christina's character was agitating. So another thing with Dr. Weber that changed a lot was Catherine kind of reinstated his job, but in a different title, and they get back together. I don't like Catherine and Dr. Weber together. I don't like Dr. Weber with anyone. That's another person that I felt like, I don't know, his love life is very messy for me, and I don't like what they're doing with it. It's just this back and forth with Catherine is just not fun enough for me. So him and Catherine come back, and I don't like that. I don't care for that. But another couple, they're really like, I really hope it ended in those two episodes. Joe and Jackson Avery, stop it. Don't do that. That was so unnecessary. That was so not needed. That was so not worth it. We didn't need to see that. I don't like Joe in general. I don't like her character. I don't see the point with the character. I need them to bring Stephanie back, because why they killed her off, I don't understand. Well, she wasn't killed off. I'm hoping she quit. I loved Stephanie's character of all the interns. Joe, a mess. I don't like her. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna set the highlighted parts. As you can see, it kind of minimized when I put a little bit of foundation on top, which I do kind of like. So what I use to minimize is my MAC powder NW43. I put that one first because when I put the Sasha Buttercup on top, it doesn't leave it super ashy. Sasha Buttercup tends to leave you a little ashy than I want, so I normally just end up just going in with a powder first and then lightly go with the Sasha Buttercup on top. So that's what I'm gonna be using to set my foundation, my highlight, a little bit, just like light, because I also am going for the soft look. I really do like that look. Moving on, one thing I really appreciate that they touched based on is the Asian characters of the show. There's a guy who comes in for, you know, they were doing the checkups outside and stuff like that, and he says, I don't want an Asian doctor. And then I really loved the response of the guy that was doing the, you know, check-in entry. And with this going on, we really are overlooking the fact that a lot of, you know, Asians are going through a lot with this pandemic. It's bringing a lot of racial energy towards them. Even in Vancouver, we've had some cases where like people are just going through that. So like, that was a very good touch. And I think Chicago Med kind of mentioned it. Dad who was like, yo, I can't be going through this. My kid is sick. There's a whole virus that could affect her body. And then I'm Asian, I'm going through it. So that was an easily almost overlooked situation, but I'm so happy this show's kind of showed it. So now, I don't know how I feel about Maggie. I don't know. Like, Maggie is another character for me. I'm just like, okay, it's there. I still haven't grasped what Maggie is doing, but what her boyfriend did was so sweet. That was so so cute, but then Maggie is just so emotionally unavailable. So sometimes I always be wondering why they put her in these relationships that just, at the same time, I really appreciate and like how she's a good aunt to Meredith kids. And then we get to Meredith, you know, star of the show. Meredith and DeLuca, I don't know if they're together. I don't know. That relationship just kind of like phased out without us even knowing what the hell they're doing. But I'm gonna be going in with my powder that I'm gonna put on my non-highlighted places, and I'm gonna go in with my brush. This is the black or pearl. I'm just gonna write everything on screen, or I'm just gonna put in my description below. So I don't know what's going on between DeLuca and Meredith, although I was shipping them heavy, and the fact that they're just letting that phase out, I'm not feeling it like that. I'm not feeling that doctor, that pediatric doctor, the bold one, feeling him either. I don't know, he's not my favorite. I haven't seen anything super tremendous about him. So I set my, you know, foundation and stuff. So I'm just gonna go in with my Sasha Buttercup on top of the MAC powder I put in. So lastly, for Grey's Anatomy, they dropped a little Derek at the end. You know, it's like the Pope Smoke album. They dropped Dio at the end. They dropped a little Derek at the end. I'm hoping it's the situation where Meredith goes in a coma and she sees Derek. Derek gives her the light to go and date other men, because she hasn't been having the most fortunate situations with relationships. So I'm hoping, and little me is hoping, that Derek is kind of giving her a blessing. Hopefully she doesn't die. That was it for me when it comes to Grey's Anatomy. Literally, that was it. Like, that was it for me. Like, I wasn't feeling it. 2 hours of boo. So while this is setting, the rest of my face is setting. As you can see, my eyelids are so like oily. I'm gonna show you what I do, just, you know, to keep them matte and clean. So I go in with the same e.l.f. concealer, and I just put a little bit there, and I mix it with my foundation because I like the consistency it gives me. The e.l.f. has like a really thick consistency, and then my foundation just gives it color. The Good Doctor goes number one for me. Couple of reasons. The Good Doctor managed to get my emotion. When I watch stuff, and I'm also a visual learner, so I'm hoping to take something out of it. At the same time, I'm hoping it gets my, you know, my emotions. Like, so I'm just gonna go in with it. It's a little too lighter than I wanted, but that's okay. We're gonna fix that. So I just go in with a brush all over the lid, and then I'm gonna blend it out with my beauty blender. See? 1, 2. You can use it as many times as you want. One of the biggest things the Good Doctor did, like I was saying, I'm someone who gets moved a lot by, you know, my little old emotions get I get so emotional when I watch TV shows, especially if they're really like moving me. The Good Doctor managed to grab I cannot talk today. So I'm gonna set my eyelids with my Fenty Beauty powder in Nutmeg, and I'm just gonna take a fluffy brush like this. So the biggest thing for me out of every show, one of the biggest things, because the Good Doctor did point out different stuff, it shows patients that survive. Like, that was one thing I wanted to hear. That is one thing I wanted to see. There is a particular patient that Dr. Andrews and Dr. Sean Murphy were dealing with, and his situation, it seemed as though he could have easily passed, but no, he survived. They showed throughout, from when he got tested, they said, you have, but your symptoms are not bad, so go home. He comes back, it's kind of worse, and they admit him. He has to go through a ventilator. Stuff like that made me just be like, oh my god, like, this was exactly what was happening. So Dr. Murphy's social skills still need a lot of work. And however, in this situation, they highlighted something that I think we all overlook every time. So Dr. Claire Brown said, it's so hard, don't quote me, I'm not going word for word here, she said, it's so hard to see emotions, to see what these people are thinking, to see what the, you know, what's going on with them. Basically, she was just talking about, you know, what people are going through, but she can't tell because people have masks. So she was just saying like, it's so difficult for me to read a person's emotion. Murphy says, this is how I live every day, pretty much all he was saying was, this is my life every day. And that is something that we forget. He has autism. He's a brilliant, smart doctor, but he also cannot read people on a normal day, mask or no mask. That's a big one. That was a huge one for me, because I'm like, I work in this industry, you know, so I see the struggles that these people are going through every day. And sometimes, even if I work in it, I really forget that they can't tell what I'm thinking, mask or no mask, you know. So that was a huge one. Another one I really liked from The Good Doctor is they showed, okay, this is small, but I'm hoping they do have an episode on that where they kind of broaden the conversation and the topic of Black Lives Matter. So her name was Dr. Audrey Lim. She is the chief of surgery in The Good Doctor. She wore a Black Lives Matter t-shirt, but then it did make a statement, right? And so I'm hoping they do make a bigger, you know, episode on that, because that was one of the biggest things that happened this year. The Good Doctor really did get my emotions. Can you guys tell me why I didn't know Dr. Melendez died? I didn't know. Like I said from the beginning, I hadn't watched The Good Doctor in a long time, so I was super, like, you know, behind. My guy shows up as a ghost, because Dr. Claire Brown, she got super close with him in season 3, so she was like, she was just going through it with this, you know, pandemic and stuff like that. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna set my face. I'm gonna use the Morphe Continuous Mist. I have talked about this before. This is like my favorite setting spray. So she's kind of like just going through it with you know, the stress of being a doctor. So there's this one particular patient that dies, and the daughter is like very persistent. She keeps coming back. She's like, I want to get something that my mom always had since I didn't have a funeral. I just want closure. Our lovely, nice Dr. Claire Brown, is her emotional self, is gonna go and get whatever the hell it was. I think it was a necklace. So she goes and takes the necklace and sanitizes it or cleanses it or whatever it is and gives it to the girl. And Dr. Melendez comes to her as a ghost. Okay, it was a sad thing. I'm making it super small, which is mad petty. One thing about Claire, I need her character to change. I need her to be more firm than like the other girl. I forget her name. She's not my favorite, so I don't even need to know her name, to be honest. Now, I know this is supposed to be a soft look, but I cannot live without my highlighters. I'm gonna go in my Revolution makeup palette, Makeup Revolution London. You see this color down here? That's what I'm gonna use as my highlight, very lightly though. She goes and finds another necklace and goes and gives it to this old man. She goes through days, and then Melendez is like, why are you doing this? Why do you feel the need to be doing this and stuff like that? And basically she just has closure issues, because he kind of points out that you are trying to find closure in the different places. When your mom died, you tried everything you could to not feel it, and now you're doing everything you could to not feel this one, especially for something you didn't experience.
Oh goddamn, what happened?
You know me, I feel like it's my duty to watch everything. I go back and I watch season 3. You can go without highlighter in this situation, but I love putting highlighter. I'm gonna go a little bit again with my continuous setting mist. So this is my final look, you guys. So just like, you know, finishing off what we were talking about. So my final thoughts, basically, all the medical shows did tap into a little bit of this and that, but I always have like the best that really like came to me, and that was, you know, The Good Doctor. They tapped into the medical staff, the patients' friends and family, what people were feeling, each person was feeling, which I feel like the other two shows did try to grasp, but that they didn't grasp it. So, you know, that's only my opinion anyway. This eye is so sensitive, so I keep lifting the lash. That was pretty much the shows. It was alright. Oh, I'm forgetting, Dr. Sean Murphy is like literally going through breakdowns because he wants to see Leah. There's a pandemic, he can't see her, he thinks she has it because she hadn't answered her phone or something for a couple of days, something about that. And you know, if you get to watch The Good Doctor, you really forget that Sean Murphy is actually pretty funny. His character is very funny. If you guys want to watch The Good Doctor's Review from a medical standpoint, I would suggest you watch, I think his name is Dr. Mike. I'm actually subscribed to him. I don't know why I'm forgetting his name. Yeah, Dr. Mike reacts to The Good Doctor episode. He uploaded it yesterday, and it was actually, he broke it down very quickly about what I was saying, but I was just talking more on my own personal experience. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you guys like this look. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll be talking to you guys in my next video.